Hello, my lovely peaches. It's Saturday, and I am going to soon share this video. I'm looking over there because I'm looking at the video I'm about to share. So if you're watching this, then I've already posted that video called It's Not All About Wendy. And I want to give a little outline for what you can expect in this video. So first I'm going to talk about somebody who said I was annoying. Then I'm going to show a couple clips that I screen recorded and transcribed. One is a clip of Donna and Harvey right at the arrest, where I'm going to show that I don't see Harvey having a phone. Then I'm going to show a 10-minute clip of Wendy's testimony in the Katie McBenoit trial. I gotta find out the name of that lawyer. And then I am going to show those same clips, but somebody's over there parking. Let me go inside. I'm gonna show those same clips, but with myself. Superimposed, and I'm going to give commentary. I'm going to give my opinion. I might pause and rewind. I might zoom in, and I'm going to talk about it. I'm going to talk about my thoughts, and I might ask questions, and I'm going to ask you to ask questions and comment if you have. Okay, so that's the outline of this video. Okay, my lovely peaches. So, the person who said I was annoying. Where's my notes? So, I wanted to acknowledge. Hello, you're so annoying. I can't even listen to this guy. Commenter, user 913758-54099Z. With no content. I just wanted to say thank you for pointing out that I'm annoying. And impossible to listen to. I appreciate you. You are valid, you know?
So no annoying sounds, right?
Does this count as annoying?
Very.
You know, as a baby sister, of course I'm annoying. As a big sister, of course I'm annoying. As a middle child, of course I'm annoying. As a YouTuber, of course I'm annoying. As somebody who likes to wax on and on and on, talk for hours, zoom in, rewind, analyze, look at somebody's facial expressions, pull apart every word they said. Of course, that's going to be annoying, but only to people who aren't interested. So sometimes I go off on little tangents and I talk about my personal life, or I talk about whatever I'm doing that day, or I'll post a super long video analyzing something that interests me, whatever that might be. And I invite you to. And so as we begin the video, I invite anyone who's not interested to leave. Also, just want to add that this could be Wendy singing this part about wanting to get on a boat. Bye-bye.
I think I go back to San Juan.
I know a boat you can get on. Bye-bye.
Uh-huh. Everyone there will give big cheer.
Everyone there will have moved here.
And for the rest of you, let's enjoy the video. So, let's get into this video, okay? So, hello, Mr. Annoying Guy. And goodbye. Thank you for your comment. And YouTube flagged you as potentially inappropriate. So thank you. Okay, now to those of you who are here because you want to be. Hello, my lovely peaches. Isn't this so cute? I'm going to just take a second to show off not this adorable cup. I got these cups from my sister for my birthday. And I got these little straws to go with it, which are cute, but we already broke like 3 or 4. And I got these Post-it. They're not actually Post-it brands, but they're like Post-it type. And they've got cactus. I forgot for a second, I have them in my drawer, my cute drawer of this adorable thing. You can't see it. I had them in my drawer in this cute thing that I forgot. All right, so this is one. There's 6 designs. This is not sponsored or anything. If you're interested in these, though, I can link it in the description. They're very cute. I just got them from Amazon. I'll see how they work. Aren't these adorable? I'll put a timestamp for when the actual video starts. Okay. Hanging plant. Oh my gosh. Is that annoying? Enough for that. Now on to the video. All right. So, like I already said, I'm going to show a clip of Donna and Harvey. The first few minutes of Donna's arrest, and I did see Donna has a white phone, and at some point there is a black phone that falls on the floor, and I don't think it's Harvey's. I think it was another cop that was standing, one of the cops who was reaching for the phones. You see all these hands, and I think maybe one of the cops dropped their phone, because I don't see Harvey with a phone. If you see it, then please point it out. Timestamp where? Or if it's not in this video and somehow it's in another shot. I know that there are other videos of other cops. Oh God, should I go down that rabbit hole and look for the other angle? Then this video is gonna really get long. Thanks again to Gigi, Pretty Lies and Alibis. I went over to her page, which is where I knew I had seen. I didn't actually get a chance to watch the videos yet, but I saw that she had posted Donna Adelson arrest videos, different body cam versions. So I did just go watch. The second version is already past the point where the phone is taken, and the first version, I still don't see a phone in his hand, so I will still call it inconclusive, but I think somebody had commented that his phone was confiscated maybe another time with an arrest warrant, but the whole reason I'm mentioning this is because I thought it was so weird that he was reaching for the phone and saying, I don't want to give it to you, but it was Donna's phone. Even if they still had taken his phone, it seemed like it was her phone that he was reaching for and saying, I don't want to give it to you. Why do I have to give it to you? So that was the point that I was making. And the whole way he's like, I have to go. I mean, it's so heartbreaking. It's so sad. It's just like, why were you so terrible? Oh, and that car driving by just made me remember I wanted to say. I was sitting here for like 5 minutes waiting for the trains, the planes, and the cars, trains, planes, and automobiles to stop so I could speak. But that's where I live. Trains, planes, automobiles, birds, seagulls, and what have you. People talking, and yeah. So welcome to my world. And then I show about 10 minutes of Wendy Adelson. She is testifying in Catherine McBanawa's trial, and the lawyer's name is Attorney Chris DeCoste. And he's the one who is questioning Wendy with an eye, because she lies, because she's Adelson. So I'm going to just play the 2 clips that I screen recorded, a little bit of rewinding and zooming in, and I put the captions up. And then, if that's all you want to see, then you can stop there. But I'm going to then play the clips a second time, but with me superimposed, where I will talk over it and give some opinions and commentary. So if this interests you, then enjoy the video. And if you think I'm annoying and you can't bear to listen, then you probably aren't still here. And of course, that guy who said that will never hear my response to him, but who cares? Because you're here and I'm here, and that's all that matters. So enjoy the video.
Murderer. If you think it's impossible to spend an entire minute just saying one word on TikTok, then you're wrong. Okay? I've been practicing how to say the word murderer in an American accent. Right? And I might as go as far as to say that's the hardest word to say in American. Murderer. Hardest word to say in American. And we invented your fucking language. Because of your ers, murderer.
So I came on here just to get some captions for my video about the Adelsons, the murderers. Wendy Adelson, she's a murderer. Charlie Adelson, he's a murderer. Donald Adelson is a murderer. I think Harvey might also be a murderer. They paid hitmen to murder the ex-husband, ex-brother-in-law, Dan Markell. Dan Markell was murdered by the murderess, the murdering family. His in-laws, his ex-wife, are murderers. And Charlie Adelson was convicted of soliciting for murder, and he's going to jail forever for that. That's how you say murder. So the attorney who is questioning Wendy Adelson is Catherine McDonough's defense attorney.
Alfredo Garcia, the less you know, the better. That's what Sigfredo Garcia said to Catherine McVanua in 2016 over the wiretaps. It's also what this government wants from you. Because the more that you know about this case, the more facts, the more you realize that the pieces don't fit and that she is innocent.
He claimed she was innocent, but no, she was not found innocent in her second trial.
Thank you. give it to you. Why do I have to?
Because my attorney said not to.
Why do I have to give it to you?
This is evidence.
Madison, do me a favor.
Is that okay with you?
Please, you don't have to have the handcuffs on. She's not going anywhere. Please. Please.
Do you have anything in your pocket?
No.
Is that okay with you?
Please, you don't have to have the handcuffs on. She's not going anywhere. Please. Please.
Do you have anything in your pocket?
No.
No.
Why do I have
that?
Let me help you out so you hurt yourself.
Any objection?
No, Your Honor.
Be admitted as State's Exhibit 64.
No other questions. Thank you, Your Honor.
All right, thank you. Cross-examination?
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you. Ms. Adelton, this is all about
you, isn't it?
Excuse me?
This is all about you, right?
I was called to be a witness and I'm testifying, so I don't understand the question. Is it a question?
There's about 100 people in this courtroom, right?
There are people in the courtroom.
Possibly thousands watching, right?
I have no idea who's watching.
And it's all because of your failed marriage, right?
I disagree with that.
You disagree that your ex-husband is dead because of your family?
Yes, I disagree.
These jurors are here for weeks doing their civic duty because of your marriage, right?
No.
Katie's going through this ordeal because of that marriage, right?
No.
Dan Markell's parents are going through absolute misery because of your failed marriage. Isn't that right?
No, that's incorrect.
Well, let's talk about the marriage. You and Professor Markell, you met when you were in law school. You told that to Miss Kaplan. And it was a whirlwind romance, right? Right?
It was not a whirlwind romance, no.
It led to a wedding, February 26th of 2006. You had a big wedding in Boca Raton, right?
Did we get married on February 26, 2006? Is that the question? Yes.
In Boca Raton?
In Boca Raton, Florida.
And it wasn't a small wedding. It was a big wedding.
There were many people in attendance.
All right. In this marriage, it led to two children, right? Your two boys.
Are you asking me if I have two boys?
Yes.
Yes.
And Professor Markell, he was a great father, wasn't he?
He was a very good father, yes.
Those boys were his world, right?
As well as his work, yes.
And they adored him too, didn't they?
Absolutely.
Now, this marriage started to fall apart, right?
It did.
But there were problems from the very beginning, weren't there? Right?
Are you asking me, what is the very beginning? The very beginning of when we got married?
Literally at the wedding.
There were problems before we got married.
All right, so at the wedding, and the government asked you about kosherate law, right?
About what, I'm sorry?
Keeping kosher.
About keeping kosher, yes.
Right? The government. And your wedding, at your wedding, was the groom's family, the Markell family, and they are more strict than your family and friends about keeping kosher.
They do not keep kosher.
Wasn't that one of the problems in your marriage, that Professor Markell was very insistent about keeping kosher?
About his kosher rules, but those are different than his family's.
So you're saying that it wasn't a problem at the wedding, that there were people from the groom's side of the family that were there that strictly keep kosher, that they were told that it was going to be kosher food, but it actually wasn't?
So there was a misunderstanding about whether the food was going to be kosher style or more in adherence with kosher law. There was a miscommunication about that.
So you had people that strictly keep kosher eating non-kosher food, which is a big deal.
That actually is not what happened. You had, Danny was upset that it was kosher style and not strictly adhering to kosher law. So he was disappointed.
So there's problems right from the beginning.
That was a problem at our wedding, yeah.
Fast forward now to September 10th, 2012. Professor Markell, he's away on a business trip, right?
Yes.
He's in New York City at New York University, right?
I believe so, yes.
And he's doing a presentation.
I don't know what he was doing.
Your husband at the time was in New York to give a presentation. You knew that, right?
I knew he was in New York. I didn't know if he was attending a conference or giving a presentation, but he was in New York for work.
Now, you had not communicated with him for 2 days.
I really don't remember.
You text him at around 2:30 in the afternoon, right? Right before he's about to do the presentation.
I really don't remember.
But you do remember dropping the bomb on him, don't you? Telling him that you wanted a divorce.
So I did not drop a bomb on him. We'd been in therapy for several months beforehand where I'd told him several times I wanted a divorce.
Markell, he's away on a business trip, right?
Yes.
He's in New York City at New York University, right?
I believe so, yes.
And he's doing a presentation.
I don't know what he was doing.
Your husband at the time was in New York to give a presentation. You knew that, right?
I knew he was in New York. I didn't know if he was attending a conference or giving a presentation, but he was in New York for work.
Now, you had not communicated with him for 2 days.
I really don't remember.
You text him at around 2:30 in the afternoon, right? Right before he's about to do the presentation.
I really don't remember.
In the afternoon, right? Right before he's about to do the presentation.
I really don't remember.
But you do remember dropping the bomb on him, don't you? Telling him that you wanted a divorce.
So I did not drop a bomb on him. We'd been in therapy for several months beforehand where I told him several times I wanted a divorce.
You say in the afternoon, right? Right before he's about to do the presentation.
I really don't remember.
But you do remember dropping the bomb on him, don't you? Telling him that you wanted a divorce.
So I did not drop a bomb on him. We'd been in therapy for several months beforehand where I told him several times I wanted a divorce.
Divorce.
So I did not drop a bomb on him. We'd been in therapy for several months beforehand where I told him several times I wanted a divorce.
Divorce.
So I did not drop a bomb on him. We'd been in therapy for several months beforehand where I told him several times I wanted a divorce.
You say it's not a bomb, but you agree with me that he begged you to reconsider.
He was very upset and, yes, wanted me to reconsider, but...
In that phone call, he's begging you to reconsider. Please don't leave. Please don't break up our family, right?
He was very upset, yes.
And he was heartbroken. I mean, upset indicates that there was anger. What he was heartbroken, right?
That I decided to divorce him after telling him I would, yes. That I decided to divorce him after telling him I would, yes.
Despite being at NYU for a presentation, he rushes home. He gets on the next flight, right?
I honestly don't remember if he got on the next flight, but he did come home quickly.
2:30, he finds out in New York. By 11 p.m., he's walking in the door to your old house at Trescott Drive, right?
I don't know.
But you do know that when he walks in the house, what he finds, you know that, right?
Yes, I left him the papers.
You left the divorce papers on the bed, right?
Yes.
Half the furniture was gone.
Half the furniture was not gone.
A good amount of his stuff was gone.
Nothing of his was gone.
And he's like, there's no way I'm not going to have access to my kids. She was getting a hefty sum of money from him. There were some things that he was, even last month, was upset about. She had his uncle's ring, something along those lines, that she had taken, and it was like a family heirloom that she wouldn't give back. And she had taken whatever she wanted out of the house at the time.
So he was out of town.
Yes. So he had to refurnish, and he's like, I spent $10,000 refurnishing this place. And it was a big adjustment, and he didn't know what he had done wrong.
A good amount of his stuff was gone.
Nothing of his was gone.
The boys' stuff was gone, right?
Some of the boys' things were gone. I'd taken enough so that I had for the boys, but no.
You were gone?
I was gone, yes.
And so were his boys.
His boys were not gone. He saw them the next day, and they would not have been awake if he's coming home at 11 p.m.
Let's stay on topic here. When he walks in the door, the boys are not in the house, right?
Correct.
And you did not tell Professor Markell where you were taking the boys. He may have seen them the next day, but you did not let him know where you were going to be staying with his
boys. With our boys?
So you agree with me that they're also his?
Of course they're his.
And he should be entitled to know where his wife is taking his children.
Absolutely.
That's not all you took, is it?
Excuse me?
You two had a joint checking account at Schwab, right?
We did.
And you went into that account before you dropped the bomb, and you took out half of that account, right?
Correct.
Roughly $350,000. That's not all you took, is it?
Excuse me?
You two had a joint... That's not all you took, is it?
Excuse me? Excuse me?
You two had a joint checking account at Schwab, right?
We did.
And you went into that account before you dropped the bomb, and you took out half of that account, right?
Correct.
Roughly $350,000.
Half, yes.
$350,000.
I don't remember the amount, but yes.
$50,000.
I don't remember the amount, but yes.
$1,000.
I don't remember the amount, but yes.
You know that it was in the hundreds of thousands.
I really don't remember the amount, sir.
Is it that insignificant of a sum to you that you
I'm
don't remember?
I'm not saying it's an insignificant sum. I'm saying I can't attest to the amount that was there.
I'm going to tone it down now. You were unhappy in the marriage, right?
That's why I got divorced, yes.
And it happens. marriages fall apart, right?
Yes.
But you complained constantly about it, didn't you?
No, I don't think I complained constantly.
To anyone that would listen?
No, that's not true.
You agree with me that you complained to the one person that would actually do something about it.
I don't understand what you're asking.
Your big brother, Charles Adelson, you complained to him about how bad Professor Markell was and how much you hated him and didn't want to be in a marriage with him.
I definitely talked to my brother about how unhappy I was in my marriage. If that's the question, then yes. Is that the question?
Yes, that is a question. You talked to your brother, Charles Adelson, about how bad your marriage was.
I did, yes.
Let's talk about it. Gutman asked you about Charles Adelson. He's an intelligent guy, right?
He is smart.
Yeah. He's both book smart and street smart, right?
I would say so.
You would say that he's a talker.
Okay, my lovely peaches, now I'm going to put my little headphones in so I can listen to the clips without doubling up the audio and make some reactions, and hopefully you find it interesting. And if you don't want to hear my opinion and you just wanted to watch the clips and make your own opinion, that's perfectly fine. You can come back and watch again later if you change your mind, or I'll see you in the next one. All right, here we go. So I don't see any cell phone except for Donna's. It's being blocked right now, but there you see he's got tickets. Oh, here we go. He's grabbing, that's Pat Sanford. So you see both of Patrick Sanford's hands come out. You see that? Okay, I thought that was a phone, but I believe that that's actually a passport. See, the guy's holding the two passports. Harvey's holding tickets. She's got a cell phone. Under arrest for the Denmark Hill. Oh no. No. I don't want to give it to you. My attorney said not to. Because this is evidence. Now it's slowed down. So the one guy in the blue shirt hands the other guy in the brown shirt the passports. He's got the two passports in his hand. Oh, those smiles make me feel so sad. It's like they seem like such sweet people. And they probably are, except for the murder part. Okay, so. Pat's trying to grab the phone. Harvey is grabbing Donna's hand. That's the passport, not a black phone. See? That's the white phone. Harvey's holding tickets. That's Patrick Sanford grabbing the phone. He's got something in his hand. And then that cop grabs her hand. And then other cop grab. There goes the passport. He's got the phone. That's the passport he dropped. Harvey has no phone. So Harvey is grabbing for Donna's phone, saying, why do I have to give it to you? Why do I want to give it to you? Patrick Sanford saying, that doesn't matter. That's evidence. Okay, that cop's got her hand. Harvey and Donna's going like this on each other. Patrick Sanford has both his hands out and his. iPad or whatever tucked under his arm. There goes the passport down on the floor. There, he's got Donna's white phone or pink phone, whatever it is. And then, oh, he's leaning down, grabbing the passport he dropped. And poor Donna, poor Harvey. Look at that face of defeat. Oh, I have to go with her, I have to go with her. You don't have that choice. Oh, you need to grab a bag. Okay. He was like, okay. And she's like, my husband.
Please. Someone's got to help him get home. This is terrible.
Oh, man.
He's almost 80 years old. He can't come with me?
Please, can I go? To jail? No, not to jail. Please.
Someone's got to help him get home. This is terrible.
Is that okay with you?
Please, you don't have to put handcuffs on her, please. She's not going anywhere. I finally figured out what it said. Listening to it like a whole bunch of times. You don't have that choice. No, I have to stay. Please don't do this. Take the bags. Okay.
My husband's almost 80 years old. He can't.
Harvey's like, okay. Oh, no, no. Can I go to jail? Don't do this, please. Someone's got to help him get home.
Terrible.
What about? I didn't do anything. I didn't do this.
Is that okay with you?
Please don't. Please, you don't have to put handcuffs on her. She's not going anywhere, please. And they just ignore it. Do you have anything in your pockets? And then this is the other angle. You see, I don't see Harvey having a phone there. It's evidence. Put your hands behind your back. I'll give it to you. It doesn't matter. It's evidence. Why do I have to? She's under arrest. I'm gonna have you put your hands behind your back like you were praying. I'm gonna help you out so you don't get hurt. And this is another angle. Again, thank you, Gigi. What is it? Lies and alibis. Pretty lies and alibis. So this lady's catching a glimpse of the arrest. So, but that was already past the point, okay? There's Georgia Kappelman, prosecutor.
The admitted as state's exhibit 64.
This is Katie McBanawa's trial.
All right, thank you.
I think it's the, I don't know.
Cross-examination?
Yes, Your Honor.
First one or the second one?
Ms. Adelson.
That's...
This is all about you, isn't it?
Excuse me?
This is all about you, right?
I was called to be a witness and I'm testifying, so I don't understand the question. Is it a question?
Her answers are so elusive and...
There are people in the courtroom.
I've noticed...
Possibly thousands watching, right?
I have no idea who's watching.
And it's all because of your failed marriage, right?
I feel like everything she says is so super calculated.
You disagree that your ex-husband is dead because of your family.
She repeats a lot of things
that he says slowly. These jurors are here for weeks doing their civic duty because of your marriage, right?
Which can be a sign of a liar who's very calculated.
Because of that marriage, right?
No.
She also refuses to answer some simple things simply.
Because of your failed marriage. Isn't that right?
No, that's incorrect.
Well, let's talk about the marriage. You and Professor Markell, you met when you were in law school. You told that to Ms. Cavill.
These questions coming up.
And it was a whirlwind romance, right? Right?
It was not a whirlwind
romance. How long was it? I don't know. How long did they date?
This... February 26th of 2006, you had a big wedding in Boca Raton, right?
Did we get married
on February 26th, 2006?
This whole repeating,
is that the question? Yes.
In Boca Raton.
Why is she doing that, if not to be super calculated?
There were many people in attendance.
There were many people in attendance.
In this marriage, it led to two children, right? Your two boys.
Are you asking me if I have two boys?
Yes.
Yes.
And Professor it's not Mark Cal.
Professor Dan Markell.
He was a very good father, yes.
Those boys were his world.
As well as his work.
As well as his work, yes.
And they adored him too, didn't they?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Now, this marriage started to fall apart, right?
It did.
But there were problems from the very beginning, weren't there? Right?
Are you asking me, what is the very beginning? The very beginning of when we got married?
Literally at the wedding.
There were problems before we got married.
All right, so at the wedding, and the government asked you about kosher law, right?
About now she doesn't know what that means.
Keeping kosher.
About keeping kosher, yes.
Right? And your wedding, at your wedding, was the groom's family, the Markell family, and they are more strict than your family and friends about keeping kosher.
They do not keep
kosher. So why did she even marry that guy?
Wasn't that one of the problems in your marriage, that Professor Markell was very insistent about keeping kosher?
About his kosher rules, but those are different than his family's.
So you're saying that it wasn't a problem at the wedding, that there were people from the groom's side of the family that were there that strictly keep kosher, that they were told that it was going to be kosher food, but it actually wasn't.
So there was a misunderstanding about whether the food was going to be kosher style.
Because kosher style is not kosher.
With kosher law, there was a miscommunication.
It's a miscommunication. Like, again, it's like I'm vegan, so it's like
eating non-kosher.
Vegan
is
vegan. Vegan style doesn't mean anything.
You had
vegetarian means not vegan. Vegetarian means dairy a lot of the time.
Strictly adhering to kosher law.
Strictly adhering, like, either it's kosher or it's not kosher, right? Like, you can be
a
strict vegan, like, you don't wear leather like me. I don't go to the zoo.
Fast forward to September 10th, 2012.
Okay, that doesn't mean that the food is not
kosher. Professor Markell, he's away on a business trip, right?
Okay, here, now she's acting dumb again.
He's in New York City at New York University, right?
Notice how wide those fucking eyes are.
And he's doing the presentation.
I don't know what he was doing.
Your husband at the time was in New York to give a presentation. You knew that, right?
I knew he was in New York. I didn't know if he was attending a conference or giving a presentation.
Because you don't go to a conference to give a presentation.
Now, you had not communicated with him for 2 days.
You really don't remember right before you got divorced?
Right,
like, you don't?
In the afternoon, right? Right before he's about to do the presentation.
I bet you she regrets this. I bet you she wishes she didn't even call him.
You telling him that you wanted a divorce.
So I did not drop a bomb on him. We'd been in therapy for several months beforehand where I told him several times I wanted a divorce.
Kel, he's away on a business trip, right?
So I'm going to speak about how cruel, how cold she is.
Right?
I believe so,
yes. I believe so,
yes. He's doing a presentation.
I don't know what he was doing.
Your husband at the time was in New York to give a presentation. You knew that, right?
I knew he was in New York.
She's either lying, being elusive, effusive, or she really, truly just did not give a fuck about this motherfucker.
For 2 days.
Or all of the above.
I don't remember.
You text him at around 2:30 in the afternoon, right? Right before he's about to do the presentation.
I really don't remember.
But you do remember dropping the bomb, don't you? Telling him that you wanted a divorce.
First of all, they're wide the fuck open.
We'd been in
therapy. And I think you can tell that it's fake contacts. One sign of fake contacts, fake colored contacts, is that very dark line around the edge.
I really don't remember.
And you can see how they're like,
don't you? Telling him that you wanted.
They are soulless because they're like
drop a bomb on him.
Fate. It's like colored eyes. She looks psycho. Also, it seems like her irises are not
been in therapy for several months beforehand, where I told him several times I wanted a divorce.
Like, I can't believe.
So I did not drop a bomb on him. We'd been in therapy for several months beforehand, where I told him several times I wanted a divorce.
Okay, so just because you told him several times that you wanted a divorce in therapy, now that you're actually saying, I'm leaving you, it's over. She's so cold. She's so cruel. Like, look at her face. Look at her, that contempt, that hatred. Like, she's just, she's scared and she's evil and she's cold and she's mean.
You say it's not a bomb, but you agree with me that he begged you to reconsider.
He was very upset and, yes, wanted me to reconsider, but...
In that phone call, he's begging you to reconsider. Please don't leave. Please don't break up our family, right?
He was very upset, yes.
And he was heartbroken. I mean, upset indicates that there was anger. What he was heartbroken, right?
That I decided to divorce him after telling him I would, yes. That I decided to divorce him after telling him I would, yes.
Right here. It's like, just because you told him you wanted to, I mean, I get it, yes, but like the way that she did it, he's at a conference.
Despite being at NYU for a presentation.
New York? About to give a presentation?
He gets on the next flight.
And that's how you drop the bomb?
I honestly don't remember if he got on the next flight, but he did come home quickly.
2:30, he finds out in New York by 11 p.m. he's walking in the door to your old house at Trescott Drive, right?
I don't know.
But you do know that when he walks in the house, what he finds. You know that, right?
Yes, I left him the papers.
You left the divorce papers on the bed.
That's not cruel to do that.
Half the furniture was gone.
Half the furniture was not gone.
A good amount of his stuff was gone.
Nothing of his was gone.
And he's like, there's no way I'm not going to have access to my kids.
Tamar Demko has a different opinion about that based on what Danny told her.
I have some money from him.
I understand.
There were some things that...
Danny's word against Wendy's word, but Danny's dead now.
Last month was upset about. She had his uncle's ring, something along those lines.
Like a Holocaust
she had taken and family, it was like a family heirloom that she wouldn't give back. And she had taken whatever she wanted
out of the
house. At the time.
She'd taken whatever she wanted out of the
house. Yes. So he had to refurnish, and he's like, I spent $10,000 refurnishing this place.
So if she didn't take anything of his, then how did he need to spend that much money, right? So she did take stuff of his.
He didn't know what he had done wrong.
Divorce papers on the bed.
On the bed.
Yes.
Half the furniture was gone.
Half the furniture was not gone.
A good amount of his stuff was gone.
You're lying.
Nothing of his was gone.
The boy's stuff
was gone. Nothing of his
was
gone. You're lying.
Some of the boy's things were gone. I'd taken
enough
so that I had for the boys, but no.
You were gone.
I was gone. Yes.
And so were his boys.
His boys were not gone. He saw them the next day, and they would not have been awake if he's coming home at 11 p.m.
Deflecting.
Let's stay on topic here. When he walks
in the
door, the boy is not in the house, right?
Correct.
And you did not tell Professor Markell where you were taking the boys. He may have seen him the next day, but you did not let him know where you were going to be staying with his boys.
With our boys? Yes.
With our boys? Yes.
So you agree with me that they're also his?
Oh, I'm going to be happy when she's
arrested. And he should be entitled to know where his wife is taking his children.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
It's not all you took, is it?
But he didn't know.
You two had a joint checking account at
Schwab,
right?
We did.
She's nervous.
And you went into that account before you dropped the bomb. And
check
you took
this
out,
out
half of that account, right?
Correct.
Roughly
I think she's
$350,000.
Nervous about this.
That's not all you took, is it?
Excuse me?
You two had a joint... That's not all you took, is it?
Excuse me?
Excuse me? Look at her face. Now on silent. She's so nervous. She's squinting. She's shaking. She's laughing. And now in flip. She's nervous.
You two
and
had
I think
a
she
joint
also has Botox,
Schwab,
by the way.
Right?
We did.
Which
and you went into that
I think is why half of her forehead is wrinkleless. And then the top half has wrinkles.
Roughly $350,000.
Half, yes.
$350,000.
Yes. I don't remember the amount, but yes.
She doesn't remember the amount.
I don't remember the amount, but yes.
$1,000.
So I think that's part of the affect.
You know that it was in the hundreds of
thousands. Virgin. It was.
I really don't remember the amount, sir.
Is it that insignificant of a sum to you that you don't remember?
It's an insignificant sum. I'm saying I can't attest to the amount that was there.
I'm going to tone it down now. You were unhappy in the marriage, right?
That's why I got divorced, yes.
And it happens.
That's why I got divorced.
Marriages fall apart, right?
Yes.
But you complained constantly about it, didn't you?
No, I don't think I complained constantly.
Do you think she sounds like Charlie when she complains?
No, that's not true.
You think she learned from Charlie how to complain?
To the one person that would actually do something about it.
I don't understand what you're asking.
Your big brother, Charles Adelson.
Your big brother who's a motherfucking bitch who goes on and on and on and on and on. Is that where you learned to be a bitch?
Didn't want to be in a marriage with him.
You just complain and complain and complain.
I definitely talked to my brother about how unhappy I was in the marriage, if that's the question.
I believe you too.
Is that the question?
Yes, that is a question. You talked to your brother, Charles Adelson, about how bad your marriage was.
I did, yes.
Let's talk
about it. I did, yes.
Government asked you about Charles Adelson. He's an intelligent guy, right?
Your lips.
He's smart.
Yeah. He's both book smart and street smart, right?
I would say so.
You would say that he's a talker.
And then he says he's got the gift of gab, and she says, I wouldn't say that. Well, girl, I think you're guilty. Okay, see you in the next one.